All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Jared Lazerson. He's a director with MGX Minerals. And Jared, it's nice to see you again. How are you?
Hi, Steve. Good to see you.
Yeah, so super interesting news release out today. And if this were 10 years ago, this news release probably wouldn't happen. But where we are today in the world and the word silicon, maybe you can explain to everyone what we're talking about here, because this is something that's in demand now.
Sure. Well, silicon really is the key metal in the modern era. I think everybody is aware of that, particularly now with solar panels being so fundamental to the clean energy revolution. So you have obviously microchips in high demand. Many products, and particularly automotive, has been severely affected by the lack of silicon and processing for chips. But also on the other side, you have solar panels. And then a lot of people aren't aware, silicon is a fundamental in silicon carbide, which is structural steel used in automotive, construction, and aerospace. So you just have a massive global shortage. The price of silicon has effectively doubled. You're now north of $2,000 a ton, US in China, which is the benchmark. So as in all things in mining, if you wait long enough, eventually commodities will shift for one reason or another. Very simple on the supply demand side. And we've had these projects now upwards of 4 years. I think we bought our first silicon project 5 years ago. A number of them are drilled, ready to go in terms of quarrying. We're working with one of the largest equipment manufacturers in the world in terms of getting a furnace in place. Fairly simple process, basically quarry, load it up in the hopper, melt it, with a downspout, basically pour it out and crush, and away you go off to Asia for distribution.
Okay, and you've done a deal with the Dongbang Metal Company, so it's good to have a supplier right away. So is this an exclusive contract for them, or is this just one of a number of them you're hoping to get?
Well, this is really the beginning of what we see as a fundamental non-ferrous metals partnership. Dongbang is one of the top non-ferrous metals companies in Korea with access to the Japanese and other Asian markets. We're looking to enter an exclusive partnership with them. We're still in the early phase as we do not yet have production of silicon, but we see that occurring within the next year. And we're also looking at a number of non-ferrous metals that MGX holds, in particular in the same region actually as our silicon projects. We have magnesium, which is again an advanced material, non-ferrous metal. So the founder of Dongbang was one of the top, actually a board member of the Non-Ferrous Metals Association of Korea, extremely well-versed in non-ferrous metals, a major supplier to a number of automotive companies in Korea. And as you know, you have Kia, Subaru, a wide variety of auto parts manufacturers or automotive manufacturers. They're an auto parts manufacturer as well as distributor for non-ferrous metals. So we see this at the beginning of a really inroads into the key manufacturing market in Asia.
And last question on this is, so you mentioned that it's going to take a little while to get that up and running. So is that going to be a big focus in 2022, Jared?
Absolutely. We're pounding away on this one every day. Again, you're just talking about one piece of equipment. We're not looking at large scale production at this time. The target right now under the LOI is 1,000 tons per month. So 12,000 TPY tons per year. We see this as really the way to get up and running relatively quickly in terms of permitting, but also just in terms of construction. The cost of the equipment is relatively low, and there are just no major barriers. So the mine side is, or the quarry side is quartzite, so totally benign in terms of environmental. And with a small piece of equipment, we're looking to get this going really ASAP. And we have this fundamental equipment partner that's throwing a lot of weight behind it. So we don't necessarily have to employ a dozen engineers to design and construct this. We've got some real support, and we've identified a number of mill sites in the area. The area's got a half dozen timber mills. So again, many brownfield sites close to the quarry. And then we have Gibraltar and two other properties in the area. So we have enough feedstock under these types of quantities to go for decades.
All right, we'll leave it there. Jared, thank you so much. Great to see you again, and we look forward to talking again soon.
Thanks so much, Steve.
All right, there's Jared Lazerson, a director with MGX Minerals.